Cancer, unfortunately, is something that humans and dogs have in common. But this means that cancer researchers can look at both species in their search for a cure.
This is where the primary tumor is.
It's called comparative oncology, and UC Davis is a national leader in this area of research. UC Davis Comprehensive Cancer Center and the UC Davis School of Veterinary Medicine have teamed up for a research study. It looks at new ways that immunotherapies can be used to treat cancer. Immunotherapies use the body's own immune system to fight diseases, including cancer. This includes interleukins that can activate T cells and natural killer cells that attack the cancer. The treatment has to be delivered carefully.
The problem with these interleukins is they're very, very powerful, so they can have side effects and toxicity. And so it really hasn't worked very well when given by some of the standard ways we give drugs, like IV or as an injection.
One more time.
Inhaled immunotherapy with interleukin 15 is something that we've really pioneered here at UC Davis. Our idea was to take it and give it as a breathing treatment into the lungs so that we could get it concentrated in an area where cancer often goes and is a major problem of cancer spreading to the lungs, and have it work there but not get to the rest of the body.
Come on, Tyson!
Tyson is one of the first patients to use this inhaled immunotherapy. With approval to use this therapy in dogs, his owners hope it can treat his cancer and extend his life. Treating family pets like Tyson is a hopeful first step toward reaching clinical trials in humans.
Some of the dogs have had very impressive results from the treatment, and we're learning a lot, which we think is going to improve the therapy for both dogs and people, and hopefully become, at one point, a standard therapy.